Something to discuss, apparently. I'll be at Milton's place in the Skyline Lofts 2A. Sorry, baby. I'll explain everything later.
Well, it seems like we have to head downtown. But you can't just yet do that, so we will have to report back. some apocalyptic nectar. Hey, fatty.
Hey there, hot stuff.
Yeah. I have some dirt on Muddy.
So what'd you find out about Muddy?
The dirty one has deserted the lady.
Alright then. I'll have to call in some bounty hunters to help me find Muddy and a couple of other jumpers. Thanks for all your help.
No worries, mate. Of presidents.
Oh, right. Sorry about that. Here you are.
I'm no longer here.
See you around then. If you ever find yourself or a loved one locked up, please call.
Will do. Your neck is as red as the luscious liquid. Farewell. Oh, that's it for our dealings with she apparently likes to call him. So it is on to... Okay, let's head into the asylum then. I'm sorry if the sound will be loud here. I mean, it is a nightclub after all. You can't expect them to be all relaxing, but I'll try to edit it if it gets too bad.
What do we have here? Another scrumptious young plaything straight out of life and into my club? You smell new, little girl. Like fabric softener do on freshly mowed astroturf. Oh, I'm not frightening you, am I, duckling?
I see before me a beauty who shares the madness of my mind.
What? Oh my, a Malkavian. This ought to be absolutely delicious. Your mind is crazy as ours, and who knows just what might happen.
Who knows? Greeting, daughter of Janus.
Oh, but you've got it bad, little girl. Not sure exactly what is real and what isn't. Janus, let's see. Isn't that a two-faced Roman god? Of course, you're right. You just happened to meet the prettier face first.
I know this isn't traditional ASMR, but her voice compared with, you know, that just makes the hairs on my arms and legs stand up. You are the whiteness, she of alabaster and ivory.
Wait until Therese hears that. I am white to her black. She'll be absolutely furious. Of course, I won't be wearing white.
Tell me your name, daughter of Janus.
I'm the finger down your spine when all the lights are out. I'm the name on all the Malaysian walls. When I pout, the whole world tries to make me smile. And everyone always wants to know who is that girl.
My heart beats like a thousand primal drums. Give me the gift of your name.
I am Jeanette. And this bit of chaos crammed in a certifiable giggle is my club. I just love to give you funny feelings all night, sweetheart, but I really must trouble with some business. We'll reunite Sweden soon, I promise.
You better. Of Janus.
Janus? What the hell are you talking about? Why are we here?
The sisters spawned from the two-headed gods. a friendly face. Hey, boy. I'm not gonna sing that song. Cold and cool. What say you? The nasty dude you would not speak of. Things are you doing for him?
Oh, man. Wow. Bertram had been keeping an eye on this guy. This Asian dude must be poking around Santa Monica. Bertram thought he might be a vampire or something like a vampire. I don't know.
A life eater from across the sea.
Life eater? I don't even know what that means. Is that right? That little scary ass Asian dude could probably kick my ass.
Tell me more of this creature.
Oh man, this guy, this thing got wise to me. Now instead of me watching him, he's watching me, you know? See, this guy is moving around me all the time, like, I'm from a distance watching me, he'll warp up next to me.
The truth does not match the words that fall from your mouth. Saying that you're a liar. Truth to your words be made. But we are. Do speak.
Come by here. Planet B and told me what to say about the Asian guy, but it's true. I swear. And everything else is true, too. This Asian guy needs to be taken out. Do it. Bertram needs you to.
To me, direct the shadow lurker. Does not this license tell the tale of his location, maybe?
No, the picture on the license isn't him. I don't know why he had it, but, well, it might help you find out where he is and what he's doing. Here, take it.
I will rain blood down on this eastern nightmare. Nasty dude. You are not who you are. I must go.
Concealing that dirty, diseased mind, sin! You have no sin. Let's see who is without sin, cast the fierce crown. Go ahead and mock me. You pull your pranks, make fun of my ways. It suits you. You're just one big joke. Don't you call me that! Should I start calling a duck a pig as well? I'm your sister. How can you treat me like this? That's it, Jeanette. Run away from the truth. I'll take care of everything, as always.
Sisters. I think we've seen that one already. Let's us meet the dark daughter of Janice. Cute.
Please, come in. I do apologize for my sister's crassness if it made you uncomfortable. She's unabashedly scandalous, but in the club business, I suppose that kind of personality is a necessary evil.
Are you Therese, the dark daughter of Janice?
Therese Vorman, yes. I'm the proprietor of this club, and the only person in this city whose good side it's in your best interest to stay on. What brings you to Santa Monica? Exile is self-imposed, I assure you. But then, what reason would I have not to hate that loathsome Nosferatu scoundrel? Like Nosferatu. They're so unclean.
I don't want to meddle with your madness, just to make no wormy peace.
I'd be willing to put the word out that my grievances with Tongue have been swept under the rug. But in return, you'll have to help me remove a particularly burdensome spirit from a property I'm looking to invest in.
Spirit, a reflection of the living.
Oh, I forgot. You're still new to this. Allow me to break you in. Yes, ghosts exist. Werewolves, mummies, and I'd expect a whole lot of other things I've never seen share the night with us. That a personal item of a ghost may be used to draw it out or excise it from its haunt. While I don't put a lot of stock in hearsay, it's my last option. So I want you to go to the Ocean House Hotel, find an item of the spirits, and bring it back.
And if this trinket will not be found...
If you have to tear the building apart, do so. Three construction crews have already refused to go back to work because they've been spooked, so to speak. You don't. They're perfectly harmless.
They are, If you will give word to the worm that he is not wanted, I will go.
Oh, I fully intend to do so. You'll find that dealing with me on the whole is appreciably more predictable than dealing with some of the egomaniacs that are my peers. So long as our business doesn't go sour, my word is gold.
Your words are like the reddest nectar, dark daughter. Farewell.
Before I forget, take this. The only way to reach the ocean house this time of night is through a tunnel in the sewers. You'll need that key to open the gate for that tunnel.
I will do what needs be done, Dark One.
If you'll excuse me, I've got situations to set straight.
A few more answers from your gray matter. Why is so much hate between you and Warm?
He meddles in my affairs. He's a bad influence on my sister and she on him. If you were in my place, would you let him compromise your authority? You most certainly would not. I'd quite like it if I never had to hear that name again.
Tell me of your sister, the White Princess.
Jeanette is the freak show I keep around to lure in curiosity seekers. She's very good with the clientele, but her business skills are approximate to those of a 4-year-old with a $1 bill and a 5 and dime.
Can I pull some answers from your mind? My mind is gone.